good day, everyone. What a wonderful celebration it's been so far. Tristan, you did an amazing job outside.
Yeah.
But I must admit, I've actually had to rewrite some of this because you used half of my material. So cheers. Okay, so it's great to see and meet all of you guys. We have the Crazy Potter fan. We've got the Aussies somewhere, cheer for here. We've got Zuni friends over there on the table. All of our British family and friends. So we have the Army Arc, if you haven't already met them. To both Wills and Jackie, that you guys have made it all the way over here, or maybe some of you just want an excuse to come to New York for each other, please. So I've never done this before, so I was looking up best man speeches on Google, and I had a lot of mixed advice. You have the standard, the Oxford Dictionary describes love as the endless humiliation of the groom, compliments to the bride, and stories that only people involved would understand. So I took this on board, disregarded most of it, and had to start up my first ever best man speech. And considering that it's for my only brother, there shouldn't be much pressure. So here goes. Firstly, I think we can all agree that Jackie and her bridesmaids look absolutely stunning. And to the bridesmaids, you did a great job in convincing her to actually stay and attend today. You look absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah.
And the fact that Will somehow managed to peel off his standard uniform, sweatpants and a hoodie is quite frankly amazing to me. So well done, bro. For those of you who don't know me, even though my dad just introduced me, I'm Will's younger brother, Ollie. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about how I know Will and my fondest and worst memories of him. So at first, I was a little surprised that he chose me, owing to the fact that he mercilessly ignored and teased me throughout my toddler period. He would flat out ignore me in the school dining hall, even if Mum and Dad had asked me to tell him an important message. He would literally sit there as if no one was around him. And at many times, I would wish for older brothers and sisters. Luckily, I had McMillan's. There you go. The Hulk girls. So a massive shout out to all of you guys for making my life bearable. However, now I realise that I'm now here speaking to you all, that it just goes to show how far we've come and how our relationship has grown. I have to make a special shout out to Will's godparents, Helen and Stephen, because if, in all honesty, we only just realised this a minute ago, if they didn't get married 33 years ago, my mum and dad would not have met. Therefore, me and Will would not be here, and none of us would be here now. So when we were toddlers, we were able to tolerate each other at best. We were typical 90s kids, playing with our action men, watching gladiators live and kicking together, playing as army men outside, as most army brats did back then. Oh, and one of my favourite memories is actually us pretending to be the ever popular 90s boy brother trio, Hanson. With Will playing on the guitar, which was a tennis racket, myself on the bin drums, and actually I have a memory of Alex Duxbury joining us and playing whatever other kind of instrument we had. We were great, and it's a sight that you'll never see, so. But then he was sent off to boarding school at the tender age of 8, and that was the beginning of the end. He would come home at the end of term time, and I would be so excited to see him. However, something wasn't quite right. He changed. He was suddenly cool, had all these friends I'd never heard of, and all this new lingo. He was playing things like rugby and hockey, building weird and wonderful contraptions in his design tech classes that I was not allowed to touch. I even had to travel 5 hours to sit and watch him play. I think the highlight of his brief stint at Stanford School was his crucial role in Midsummer's Night's Dream as Mustard Seed, with a deck of yellow tights, a yellow leotard, and covered in yellow paint. He looked great, and
know you've already won one, Tony, but if you need another, we'll...
in all honesty, I think this is where his love affair of film, TV
and theatre truly began. Will starred in many plays throughout his school career. He played a ginger twin in Shakespeare's Comedy of Errors, one of the horny residents in a little hotel on the side, to mention but a few. But personally, I think his best role was as a deaf mute at the age of 13. That was hilarious. Yeah, he was hilarious, but I'm sure we can all agree that sometimes silence is sometimes his best quality. But back to being the loving little brother I am. I looked up to him in school. He was an all-rounder. When it came down to academics and sports, Will's managed to cement his reputation in the senior school. So when I joined at the age of 13, and I'm sure most of the younger siblings here can relate to this, many of the teachers and sports coaches expected me to be just like him. On the rugby field, it was, "Ollie, pay attention, why can't you play as well as your brother?" In the classroom, Will's always got better grades than me, until he hit university and actually I got a better degree than him. One of my favourite moments was when, whilst at the shooting range, which for you Americans is fairly standard at a British private school, an overweight, probably drunk sergeant major with a thick Scottish accent came up to me and shouted in my face, "Boy, why can't you shoot like your brother? Disgrace to your family." So, a real boost to my morale. It was only when he left university that I was able to begin my campaign for the coolest little brother, which was hard to be honest, and the favourite son. When Wills went to Birmingham for uni, he did really well in meeting new people from different backgrounds and broadening his horizons, some of whom are here today. He met Rishi, who went to private school, played rugby. George, also private school, played rugby. Private school, played rugby. And Jules, private school, played rugby. So well done, Will. You really managed to get out of that school bubble. I'm sure some of the Birmingham lot remember, but I was actually lucky enough to experience a university night out when I just turned 18. I was frog marched through their student union and given all these different weird and wonderful drinks and told to strongido this and down that. I was wrecked. And the night ended up with me bent over a bin with my brother laughing at me. Yeah. You have my hair now. Guys, please don't expect to see that again tonight. I have learned my lesson. We're all good. It was during the summer holidays at university that he had his first experience of the brilliant city that we can see outside of our window. At a 10-week acting course at Stella Adler, he stayed at NYU Dorm, where he met Zach and a bunch of other people. They showed him the city, took him home for weekends, and really welcomed him. From here, this is where Will's love affair with the city really began, and his quest for a green card really took place. He came back to the city a couple times. First time was for a totally legal internship with Seth, which is where he ended up living with the ever-classy Lauren. And somehow he managed to make his way into that family, so you're stuck with him and you only have yourself to blame for that. And as you've heard from Lauren and Tristan, Lauren only realised on his last day here that there was a wonderful girl that he should meet. And you've already heard the story, they tried and tried, and finally someone managed to convince Jackie to actually add him on Facebook. And after going backwards and forwards from the UK and US, mostly on Jackie, she was the only one with a decent job. And then a brief 8-month stint in Australia, which again, didn't really want Jackie about. Will managed to persuade his job back in London to move him over here. Will was inching ever closer to that green card. I don't know much about their rough patches. However, one moment in particular, which Lauren again told me about, was when he had when he put his common sense to good use and decided to try out for the British Army. He actually only told myself and Dad, and his theory behind this was pretty standard. He was going to wait until he got accepted and then drop the bomb on Jackie. teacher, going back to school, working for some random startup company, or marriage.
Jackie, in all honesty, I think you probably know Will better than most of us do. Welcome to our small little family, and thank you for making him so happy.
And for being the one to get him really well. And you've also allowed me to really take the place as favourite son. I mean, moving 3,000 miles away doesn't make it hard. And Will's. Wilma, Shrimp, Big Willy Smalls, Shaw, Nifty Spanner, Bunty, Bro, Ambrosia, and Pain in the Neck. You ain't half bad as a big I wish you both the happiest of marriages, and I am truly happy that you have found each other. So ladies and gentlemen, it's been an emotional day. Both Gillian on the Soho tables and the cake are in tears. It gives me immense pleasure and relief and ask you all to stand and raise your glasses to you, Mr. and Mrs. Shaw.
To Jackie
from
Will.
Thank you.